Okay, so we will install Hive first today. What is Hive is Hadoop user environment. So this is basically utility or tool, you can say, that was developed by Cloudera, okay, just to integrate everything on a single, you know, web front basically. So it's like it will give you a web UI. In that web UI, you will have the connectivity to Hive, you will have connectivity to Pig, MapReduce, Scoop, you can run Uzi workflows and all. Okay, so you need not to go to PuTTY, okay, and then access individual components one by one. You can have them, you know, on a single web UI and just select there what you want to run basically. So in most of the production systems basically, Hive will be used. Again, it needs to be secured since it is a web UI. It needs to be secured in terms of basically we can install it on HDP, that is in Hortonworks. So yes, we can install, though it is not a integrated part, or it does not come with the stack of the HDP 2.5 or HDP 2.5, whatever Hadoop Hortonworks stack you will see. But yes, there would be RPM already available in the repository. Okay, so you have seen, right, how do we build our HDP 2.5 is basically we have the repository downloaded from the Hortonworks website to our local system and created our own web server, and on that web server we have put the complete repository of HDP 2.5 stack, right? In that there is one Hive RPM also available that you can install on your own and then configure, and then it will automatically integrate. I mean, in that configuration, basically in the configuration of you need to specify that which are all basically components with which you want to integrate it, and basically you just need to provide the service URLs and ports, you know, and the groups and everything. Okay, so we will configure it and automatically it will come up and it will run on one particular port. Mostly the port number would be 8000, that is what is actually appearing here. I will let you know later. So on port number 8000, basically it will start your web UI, and from there you will get the connectivity to all. So basically, if you come to Ambari and try to, aid the service from here, so basically you won't find Hive. Okay, when you install Cloudera, automatically Hive comes by default. Okay, so it will be a pre-configured thing in the Cloudera stack, but not on the Hortonworks stack. Okay, so there is no Hive here. So we need to add it, and then we will, you know, run it separately. Okay, we will make it on, or we'll make it restart as and when we restart our machine. Okay, so this is the configuration. Okay, what we need to do is basically we need to configure HDFS and Hive mostly, because this is the heavily used components in Hadoop, and further on you can, you know. So whatever configure that we do, basically it will pull everything and we'll make it up and running. So let's do that. First thing what we need to do is basically we need to install the server itself. Okay, so that is the Hive. So sudo yum install, and it should be Hive server or what? It's Hive. Okay, so Hive. Now if you see, when we install this, basically the RPM will come from our local web server repository, not from any online repository. So that will tell that we already have the RPM or executable available on our local repository. Okay, so it means that it is automatically shipped shipped by HDP 2.5 stack. So it will take some time in terms of, because it will refresh the yum. Now if you see this repository, they're all coming from HDP 2.5, right? And we have this Hive server, and then these are all you can say connectors, connector dependencies or connector for BVEX means Hive connectivity, Uzi connectivity, Pig connectivity, Hatlog connectivity, Hive server. Okay, so basically these are all having all the RPMs, right? So let me install it. Take some time. So once this will be installed, we need to configure our Hive and HDFS in order to allow the Hue user to to communicate with it. Like if Hue user wants to do some HDFS operations or Hive operation, the Hue user should be allowed in both that configuration. Okay, so let it happen. So this is done now. We need to go to HDFS and configuration, and then basically we need to put these two properties over there. Okay, so that is what is called core side XML. So core side XML, in that we need to add these two properties. So that will actually Hue groups and Hue host, all the users who are under the Hue groups or from the Hue host, basically they will be able to connect to the HDFS and do the operations. So basically go to advanced, search for core site XML. So here is our custom core site, and you just need to say 8 properties and put these two properties over there. Okay, so add them. If you see, those properties have added. Now we need to verify that web HDFS is enabled or not, right? So currently we need to enable it. Okay, so by default sometimes it is disabled, so it is already enabled, so we are good with this configuration. I am saying Hue changes and let it saved. Once it is done, we need to configure the Hive server 2 part. So we need to say do as true. It means that again we need to make this kind of impersonation for the Hue, so for the Hive server 2 user. Okay, it will it can be used through Hue, so that you can run the Hive commands or SQLs and all. So this is just like kind of making impersonation on. What is the meaning of impersonation? It is like one user is doing something on behalf of the other user. That is what is called impersonation. Okay. So this is saved. We need to restart it. Basically, before restarting, we also need to change on the Hive properties something called Hive server enable do as. So you can go to advanced and try to search this property over here. And currently it is false, so we need to make it true. TRUE true. There's a boolean property. I'm saving it. Hue impersonation on. Close it anyway. Okay, now Hive also needs to be restarted because there are some core configuration changes, and it is mandatory if you do some core configuration changes, it's always better to restart everything. So come here and say restart all required. Okay, so whatever is required will be restarted. It will take some time, around 2-3 minutes. So let them restart. We can then, by then we will configure our Hue configuration. Okay, so Hue once installed, basically you will get the Hue configuration file over here in this directory. So let me go there, and here there is a file called Hue.ini. Okay, so open it. And as per this document, we need to configure it. Okay, so web server listens on this port. So basically, this is all good. You can find values like this. Just do forward slash and try to find. So currently, it is set like that to ensure that your session keys are secure. And so there is a secret key that will be used in order to secure your session. Since it is working on web server, web UI, it is. So basically, this is a security feature provided by the Hue out of the box, just to provide your security to your session that you are having with it. So basically, it would be some secret if you see. Okay, so find out secret key. So it is secret key. So this is, I mean, basically it is around 30 characters long, and it need to be something random. Okay, so we are good with that. Don't need to change anything. Web HDFS URL. Okay, so we need to find out. So currently it is saying that localhost. Okay, so this is our web URL. It is name node port, front end port, right? 50,070. Back end port is 8020. So we need to change everything for this localhost to be our machine name. Okay, that is, what is machine name? Machine name is this master2.cluster.com. So basically you need to do like this %s, then localhost needs to be replaced with master1. Okay, master2.cluster.com. If you do like, so 14 substitution on 14 lines. So it, wherever it has found localhost, it got changed to master2.cluster.com. Okay, so we have changed everything where the localhost appears, because we are not using localhost anymore. We are having our machine name, and we need to use that. Okay, so this is done. Now yarn changes, high server to host name. I think these are all okay, but let me just try to check if it seems. Okay, so yarn cluster. It should not be yarn, actually it should be hive server 2. Okay, so hive server, it's not hive changes, it should be, oh, it's not yarn changes, it should be hive changes. Okay, hive server port 10,000. Okay, it is there. Hive server host master2.cluster.com. initially it was localhost, but now since we changed it, it got changed to something else. Okay, by default it is 120 timeout. And hive configuration directory, it is hive conf, so it is like default one. Then we need to create a MySQL, because what Hive does is Hive manages its own metadata in MySQL. Okay, basically you can have MySQL, PostgreSQL, you know, SQLite. There are a lot of options that you can choose. Find database. So you will see database. So here. Currently the default setting is SQLite, so again it is one kind of RDBMS. Okay, so we need to configure this by creating a database of Hive in MySQL and create a user and everything. So we are going to create a user identified by Hive, so it means that a Hive user will be created with his password as Hive, create a database Hive, grant all the permissions to that Hive database to the Hive user, and flush privileges. Once you do that, you will create two things. One is Hive user and another is Hive database, and then we'll provide this configuration over here so that our Hive configuration will use the Hive database in MySQL RDBMS to store all its metadata information, like you can create the separate Hive users within Hive web UI. Okay, whatever things that you will do through Hive basically will be stored somewhere in the Hive database. Okay, so let me do that. Go to MySQL, okay, and run these commands. Okay, now do use Hive, it should have been created now. If you do show tables, currently there might not be anything until unless we don't make the configuration changes and restart Hive. Okay, so once we start Hive, after doing all this configuration changes, it will create some tables in this Hive database that it will, you know, access, or that it will use to store all the metadata information related to Hive. Hive's full form is Hadoop User Environment. Okay, so once we do that, we need to provide this configuration in database. So over here we need to just comment out everything, and as per us we need to change. So we need to, engine would be MySQL, host would be master2.cluster.com, port 3306, user Hive, password Hive, name of database is Hive. So let me change that. Should be MySQL, host master2.cluster.com, right? master2.cluster.com, port 3306 is MySQL port, user Hive, password is Hive. So though it is unsecured, I mean, when we do in the production, basically we should not use the plain text password. Okay, we need to provide a file that is not readable, or we need to encrypt it somehow. Okay, then only we can pass it on. Okay, so there are multiple tricks to do that. In production, you won't see any plain text password like this. But in our case, we can use it. Okay, once we do that, basically we are good. let me save this, and now we need to run this command. Okay, source activate, and then let me try running this. So these are all what is this? Basically there are some permissions required on multiple directories later on. Sometimes it may require, sometimes it may not. If you see some permission issues, basically you need to run all these guys. Okay, if not, let me first run this. It may tell you something. Okay, so no fixture found. Let me just check if it has done. So creating table authorization permission, installing index, no fixture found, sync. Okay, migrate to this. Okay, so now once this has been successful, okay, hue sync db, we need to hue migrate, that is this command, and then finally deactivate. Okay, so everything is running fine as of now. It does not find any permission issues and it is working well. And then deactivate it. Now if you come here and now to show tables, basically you will find that there are 78 tables got created in Hue database. Okay, and these are all the metadata store tables. Basically these tables will be used in order to store the metadata information that Hue will use. Some of them might be related to Hive, some of them might be related to HDFS, some of them might be related to Uzi and whatnot. So if you see Uzi bundle, these are all like Uzi tables. Then you will have pig, then you have some BVEX on the top that is related to Hive. Okay, come out of it. Okay, now we just need to start it. Before starting, basically we need to make it check config. There's a chk config. What does it mean? What does it do? Whenever you restart your system, basically it will on it. Okay, check config says error reading information. Okay, so I'm saying cd / etc init.d. Okay, now it got check config on, and then you can just do start it. So you can run either these or you can just say sudo hue start. It says starting hue and it is started. Now just check if it is listening on port 8000. Do sudo netstate minus nltp. Crap, 8000. Currently it is listening. So basically you can open the web port now. So 192.160 and instead of 88 just put 8000. So hue has come up. Now basically hue user and hue password. Okay, so this is going to be our super user of Hue Web UI. Okay, whichever first user you will type here and its password will be the super user of the Hue console. Okay, so I have written Hue and password is also here. Sign up. Okay, and since the services might have restarted now. Okay, so everything is restarted basically. Now Hue should be tightly integrated. What you can do with Hue is basically you can go here and try to run some commands. So open BVEX. This is Hive one. Do show databases execute. So there are Hadoop underscore example and test, right? So basically though it is not the integrated part or it was not like already pre-installed with this tech, but the RPMs of Hue are there in that package. We could install it, we could configure it, and now it is seamlessly working with other components, right? You can browse the file system, We can say user, and this user hi warehouse employees employee.txt. You can download it. Okay, this is HDFS access. Okay, then hkatalog we have, Vuex already we have seen, show databases, you can do show use, I will say use Hadoop underscore example and show tables. Okay, so this is like very interactive. Okay, execute it. So basically these are all the tables, you can use any one of them, you can save the query, you can rerun it, there are a lot of things you can do. My queries, apparently there is no saved queries, there is no saved queries. Basically you can create, you can just run the history. As of now we have run this commands, results also, like these are databases. Okay, so out of the things database, you can select this Hadoop underscore example tables also, it will show you a lot of tables. Use Hadoop underscore example and see the tables out in that. I'm currently not showing. And there are settings also. Okay, you can create, you can sync this, you can sync the user. Currently there is only one user, right? Now, how does you provide the access to the multiple developers, right? Because every developer want to log into Heave using their username and profile. Then it's admin activity. Basically, you need to sync the Active Directory users or LDAP users to Heave directly. And then all the users in the Active Directory or LDAP will be able to access this Heave server using their Heave passwords. Okay, and you can further restrict the users use on multiple things. You can restrict them to open the file browser, you can restrict them to run any queries, you can restrict them to run PEG, you can restrict them to use hkatalog, you can allow some tests, you can put a lot of restriction, you can allow something like that. Okay, so everything is manageable. Okay, so but then it is more admin, towards admin activity. What, being a developer, we need to get the access to this console, that's it. Okay, so now PuTTY, and this is the second way to interact with all the components and develop your utilities and all. Okay, now this is what is Heave. Okay, we have Uzi editor, we do a job designer and all. So we are going to use this job designer and Uzi, okay, in order to perform our Uzi class in the coming session. So what is this? It will tell you more about. Currently this is the version. Okay, so these are, you have PEG, you have Hive, PEG, hkatalog, this one. Though Scoop is not as of now, but then in that Uzi job designer, you can also perform a Scoop action, email action, PEG action, Hive action, and a lot of things. Okay, so now that's what we will see next. So, any questions in Heave? So Heave is Ambari, Heave and Ambari completes everything. As an initial learner, basically most of the guys gets confused in between these two things. So Heave is basically to work with the components once the things got installed. Ambari is just to install Hadoop, okay, using Hortonworks platform. Similarly, you will have Cloudera manager for our Cloudera platform. There you will get the Heave automated, I mean out of the box. You need not to do any configuration, you need not to do anything. Just install and it will automatically be up and running. In Hortonworks, since it is not a core component of HTTP stack, basically they won't give you the addition of Heave through Ambari. Okay, they could have given, I mean it's very simple. I mean we have seen that there are a lot smaller configuration and automatically it should be installed. With that some little configuration it should be started, but then I'm not sure why they did not include this in the aid service in Ambari. Okay, they could have, since they are already shipping the Heave RPM with the package. They could also provide the way to install through Ambari so that Ambari will manage it. Okay, now currently we need to manage it individually since it is not being managed by Ambari. Okay, that is the only issue. In Cloudera stack, it is managed by the Cloudera manager. Okay, we need not to do it separately manually. So that's it for Heave.